Hi everybody, this is Vanquished Angel and welcome back to my channel. Today we're going to be looking at Quirky Linux, the Xurus, I think that's how you pronounce it, make. Now I already have it installed, so we're just going to start it up. And this is based off of Puppy Linux. It was forked a few years ago and they created their own operating system and called it Quirky. Xurus is a type of squirrel. And so we are going to be taking a look at what this operating system has to offer. Now I like the Puppy Linux operating system. I like how light on system resources it is. I like basically that it's super efficient. The only complaint that I would have about Puppy Linux itself is how redundant a lot of the programs are. And that's just me. That's just me personally. That's how I feel about the redundancy of it. So now that we got this opened up here, you can set different settings like what language or encoding you want, or you know, set the hardware clock, and you can probably click those. I don't want to screw it all up too much while I'm demonstrating this, and then you just click OK and then it will reprogram it, and then it lets you know that's running from an ISO and it's meant to be run from a full installation, but we're not doing that now, so we're gonna do that. We have more than enough RAM, and you can configure your internet or whatever there. And that's just saying that it does not work on my something. This one doesn't work on my system, which is fine. It's probably because it's in a virtual box. Now we can try to install. Okay, well we'll try to do that first. I don't think that'll be successful though. And so we're gonna click on this and I guess that's like a file manager. I clicked it twice. Let's go to downloads, nothing in downloads. So I like its layout. It's actually really simple and really straightforward. Archive, nah, other. There's not much since we're in a live ISO. I think this is the browser. I've never used SeaMonkey before, so I've never seen it before. And there, so we'll just do that. I clicked it twice because I do that. We're gonna go to Google. And it looks it up on DuckDuckGo. So the default search engine is DuckDuckGo. That's SeaMonkey. I believe SeaMonkey is created from Firefox, or at least it used to be. Or is it Chrome? Might be Chrome. Let's click right here. Huh. Alright, so add-ons manager. Well, that kind of looks a lot like Firefox. Who knows? Okay, so that's SeaMonkey. We're just gonna close. Alright, and then apps. So let's look at apps. This is easy apps. I really don't know how to use this one. Oh, it just opens the apps. Excellent. Kind of, oh cool. I like that. Finance. Close. I guess the finance one isn't too hot. What's the spreadsheet? LibreOffice. Okay, so it's like a quick open to the apps you want. Nice. I like that. That's actually a wonderful idea. Petget, which is probably the repository. We're going to close that. I always double click it for some reason. So yeah, this is what comes in your standard Puppy Linux. Okay, so there's that. We can configure Package Manager. And it uses the Ubuntu repositories. So that's cool. And the puppy ones. Let's see. Fun. What is fun? These are games. Let's see. Wine is probably in here. It isn't. It's not. I would think it would be. Well, anyway, okay, so there's a look at that. We can try to find it in here. We could probably find it in the other ones. We're not going to look for it now, though. So there's that. Oh, set up. That might be the initial screen we saw. No. It almost looks like Easy Apps. Oh, yeah, it is probably Easy Apps. Or at least it's the same window. Alright, so there's that. That's probably the terminal. There. Alright, and then this has a unique feature where it can somewhat save your loading. The goal of Quirky, unlike Puppy Linux, though, is actually to be fully installed. So, whereas Puppy Linux has an automatic saving so that you can reload it and boot from the disk again, Quirky has a little bit of that, but it's not as developed as Puppy Linux's is. So now we're going to look through here. And we have, this is like a themer almost. It's JWM Desk Manager, so GTK themes, JWM themes. Basically, it just controls how you see the whole interface. And then as you can tell, there's a lot of themers. So there's, you know, this theme chooser, and an icon switcher, which could also be done in the other one, and then Desk Manager, and then GTK Theme Maker. And so lots to do with theming. The background stuff and configuration there, and then this is basically like setting up stuff like date and time and time zone and that. So then we're going to look at the system tools. We got the boot manager, configure boot up, hardware info information, which I'm in a virtual box so that won't matter, process manager, a CPU frequency scaling tool, then we have HTOP, which I will open up for you guys. Yeah, so it uses a decent amount of memory, not too much, not too little, like Puppy Linux was really little, but it uses very little processor, so it does take its efficiency from Puppy Linux, which is good. And plus, this is all booted up into memory, so that could be why it's using more memory. And then, you know, your drive wizard and printer wizard, firewall setup wizard, connection wizard. So this is all your setup stuff. And, so there, and then we have our utility, which is Easy Apps here. You get to click and your apps pop up. It's pretty nice. For whatever it is. Or just a bunch of easy to use apps. And then, let's see. That's the pup control panel, which I'll pull that up. Yeah, and you notice a lot of these all have the same screen. There. And you know, backups, rocks file manager, gparted is in here, gd map for your disk mapping. Let's see. And then you got your graphics over here. You got lots of different types of graphics. You have this vector from LibreOffice Draw, vector graphics. Then you have Inkscape, then you have MT Paint, Simple Wallpaper Maker. And then this is like Impress, so that's like the slideshow presentation. Digital camera access, your image scanner. You have a couple of them. Photo printing or whatever. So lots to do with webcams and images and stuff like that would be under graphics. For your documents, you have SeaMonkey, and then LibreOffice, of course. LibreOffice Rocks, PDF viewers, PDF convert, join, and extract. Let's see. And then you have your business. So of course, you have LibreOffice Base and Calc. Then you have your planner. Then you have other calculators and units converter. SeaMonkey address book, Osmo personal organizer. I'm not a fan of Osmo, never really liked it. And then you got another area to set up your firewall, which is IP tables, and then Flash installer, and then you got SeaMonkey for your mail, and then SeaMonkey for your web browser, and you got Pigeon, and then a download accelerator, and then a torrent website downloader, more torrent creator, and then a torrent downloader, and then YouTube downloader. Alright, and then multimedia. It uses Zine as its player, which is kind of cool, and Asunder for CD ripping. Let's see. More CD song ripper, another CD ripper. So redundancy is huge. Graphical editor, music player, which you have Zine. And then you have PAV record. And then burn ISO to CD. So that's a there. And I believe this one, ISO Master, allows you to customize an ISO. And then you have PBurn. And then another one for burning. So lots of disk burning tools. And then jigsaw puzzle, Rubik's Cube. All right, so those are games. So there's your look at Quirky Linux based off of Puppy Linux. They separated a while ago. It has the same issue for me that Puppy Linux has, and that is it's awfully redundant. But again, this one is beautiful. I love how well it's laid out and how elegant it looks. It's just got a beautiful interface. I'm sure that scroll bar won't be there if you fully install. That's for volume. This is the network and your DNS. And so it's just network information. And this is 12 gigabytes of personal storage there, and Bluetooth. And this, I'm not sure if that's a processor or RAM. I'm gonna assume it's processor though. All right. Thanks for watching. I appreciate your time. And so that's your look at Quirky. All right, you have a good day, and subscribe if you want to see more videos or check out my other videos.